And because of the efforts that everyone has made, we're able today to make some further changes. They'll be outlined further by Dr. Chant and Minister Hazard, probably to some degree. But those changes today will include the removal of close contacts, removal of the 7-day isolation period for close contacts. In addition, today we'll be removing hotel quarantine here in our state. Hotel quarantine has proven to be incredibly successful over the course of the pandemic. But from this position that we're in now, hotel quarantine will cease. In addition, we'll also be moving from a government perspective in relation to mandates to a occupational health and safety approach. All areas of government will take risk-based assessments in relation to their areas of employment, and they will make recommendations in relation to where vaccination will be required in their specific areas. So, for example, and Dr. Chant, we speak to this, there'll be certain areas in health where vaccination will be required, just like we've had pre-pandemic for various health workers in certain settings. In addition to that as well, today we're announcing that green dots will be removed from public transport. So I want to make the point in closing. This is not the end of the pandemic. We will always tailor our restrictions, as we've said, from the outset over the last 2 years to the circumstances that we find ourselves in. But today is a day where the people of our state in New South Wales can be incredibly proud. To be in a position, we've had an incredibly low death rate. We've had we had downward pressure on our health system. And that has been because of the efforts and sacrifice that people have made. Yes, governments tailor settings. Yes, government make decisions. And for the course of the last 2 years, has been the numerous decisions and numerous steps that we've had to take to keep our people safe, to keep people in work, and to keep business in business. But overall, the balance that we've been able to strike here in our state, I believe, has led not just the country, but has led the world. And that's not on the back of the government. That's on the back of the great people of New South Wales for the efforts and sacrifices that they have made. That's what's kept our state strong. And that's what will keep our state strong even more as we head into the future. So I'm now going to pass to Minister Hazard, who will speak to this great new hospital here in Western Sydney. Minister Ayres will then speak as well. Then Dr. Nguyen from a clinician perspective and what this...
All right, so that was the Premier of New South Wales, Dominic Perrottet, speaking in Sydney. We're hearing that COVID restrictions are being wound back from 6 o'clock this Friday night. Vaccine mandates as well for government employees will also be scrapped. And right at this very minute, the similar announcement is being made in Victoria as they wind back their COVID restrictions as well. Certainly a big step forward.
Yes.
And a big step back towards normality and just getting back to how things used to be.
You'd hope so, wouldn't you?
In part.
Vaccination mandates, though. Yeah.